Okay, I'm ready to start working on my bracket that's going to hold this big stout motor to be mounted on my Hitachi. Now, this style of motor, this is what's called a flange-mounted motor. And this is a piece of 4140 3/8 inch steel that August had cut for me. And it has a perfect circle on the inside that mates the ridge on this flange. But what I need to do now is I need to, first of all, drill and tap four bolt holes in this. Now these are 15 millimeter holes here, and I don't have a 15 millimeter transfer punch, and I'm not going to go buy one just for this. So I got into my bushing box here. You know, I've got this box with all kinds of bushings and what have you that I've saved, and I found a drill collar that is just a perfect fit for down in here. I mean, I can. Just fits in there just perfect, and now I can use one of my SAE transfer punches, because that's an SAE thing, and I can just go ahead and mark my spots here. But what the first thing I want to do though is I want to clamp this here. I've got this piece of plywood drilled. With a hole in it for the shaft to go through, so it's sticking down through the center of my rebow. But let me get this clamped here, and then I'm just going to go around to all four holes, and I'm going to give it a good mark with the transfer punch and mark my holes. And you can see I've got a triangle written here, so I can always go back and get it to the exact same orientation that I wanted to make this in. And you can also see that I've got this motor tied off to the ceiling here, just in case I have a, you know, lose balance or something and accidentally pull it over. I don't want this thing to hit the ground. So here I don't really have room to get a good strike on this without perhaps running the risk of dinging the motor, so I'm just going to use a socket extension and a 3/8 inch socket, and it's not going to hurt this. Plus it's got a lifetime guarantee on it if I damage it. So let's just get a nice mark going here. Okay, there's the first one. That could be a trick to get out, huh? Not too bad. Oh yeah, that's a nice mark down there. And again, this is bad right here, although, yeah, it's really nice how they made the cutouts here, but it's still very tight. Okay, let me look down in here, make sure I got good marks. Good, good. Everything looks really good. So let me take it apart, and I'm gonna go to the drill press, and I'm gonna drill these guys out, and I'm gonna tap these holes. If it was just mild steel, I would probably do it with a nut and a bolt on. But I'm 100% confident in this 4140, which is, you know, very close in structure to like grade 8 bolts, that I'm just going to be able to use a cap screw with a washer and lock washer, and then I'll just bob it off so it's not sticking out the other end, so it'll be a nice clean look. So I'm just going to drill and tap into this plate. So I've got my taps ready here. I'll do that outside on my hand tapper, though. Okay, so I feel confident I can break this setup down now. I'll go to the drill press. Okay, so here's my plate of 4140 that's going to have my motor mounted, the flange of the motor mounted here, and I got my holes marked. This is what I had marked before. I'm going to wear gloves because it's really cold out today and I don't want to get this cutting fluid all over my hands and then have a hard time cleaning that stinky stuff off. So let me just go ahead and be a little proactive here. So I don't have these clamped down yet. I'm going to get my center marked first. Oh, and I'm going to use a half 13 coarse thread tap. So I look here at my tap and drill chart, and half 13, I use a 2764, so that's what this is, my biggest one. And I like to, this is 4140, so this is harder, so I like to go ahead and just do a step, so I'm not straining my bits or, overheating anything. And so I sharpened all these guys up, just touched them up on my angle grinder with my plywood sharpening jig that you've seen me make. So they're all ready to go here. And this is Union Butterfield tapping fluid. I just have it in this little jar because the other one cracked. So let me get this centered out on the punch mark. Shopping for a keyless chuck right now. Okay, just one more to do and then I'll go out to my hand tapper and tap these four holes. Okay, so here I'm out in the metal working part of my shop. It's outside. Normally when you see me, I'm always complaining about the heat, but now I'm complaining because I'm cold. We're not used to this kind of weather. It's only about 35 degrees right now, so it's pretty unusual for Texas. 4 o'clock in the afternoon. Want to go nice and slow. You don't want to go overboard. Don't be a maniac, especially in 4140. Probably doing about a fifth of a turn per cut, clearing those chips. The thing about 4140 that's so amazing is it's really hard, but it just cuts and machines and taps and everything so beautifully. It's just, it's a real mystery for me. I'm sure the engineers designed it that way though. Usually I keep an old nasty toothbrush right here.